to Italy part 3, the last of our little trip up the boot. This is about Cinque Terre and then sort of real northern, the Tyrol part of Italy. After our incident in southern Italy, in Naples, and the attack, we were rather rattled, and so we're still trying to settle down from that. We decided not to stop at Rome or Venice because we'd actually seen them years ago, and we'd been there, and the attack around Naples, as I say, rattled us, and we didn't want to go near cities after that for a while. So Cinque Terre, we preferred, excuse my dash cam, the Cinque Terre we preferred to the Amalfi Coast, I think mostly because we got more intimate with it. We actually hiked out and walked, and yeah, rather than using public transport and just seeing the city. So
we were a bit exhausted after the walk, must say. It was just stairs all the way up.
Up and down.
Well, mostly up the way we did it, which is actually better. But the last bit back to the car, which was on the top of the hill, I nearly died. I crawled my way up to the van. I was so pleased to be.
I almost had to tempt Hanneke with a couple of sweeties or something to get to the top.
You just disappeared. Anyway.
And then we also started using, and we found out about another app called Agricamper. And what that is it, the philosophy behind that is people inviting you to stay. It's something encouraged by the Italian government. They can register as an agricamper. It has to be a going concern of a farm or something like that. And they can make money out of having people camping on their lands. And it's then becomes tax-free to them. But the majority of the income must still come from farming or other activities. So I think the first one we went to was,
it was a restaurant.
It had a restaurant on the premises.
So it's free still to stay there, but you're obviously helping the farmer by going out for dinner there.
Or buying his
produce.
Yeah.
So it really is sort of win-win situation for everybody.
So I think we stayed at 3 agricampers in northern Italy, and the first one we went and had a dinner at the restaurant, and the next two were actually
the equestrian centers.
Oh yes, both equestrian centers. One was open and the other one actually was closed, but still allowed us to stay there.
Yeah.
And we obviously weren't interested in horse riding or anything like that, but
It's a safe place, and it takes you out into a place that you wouldn't normally go to, and it's still out in the countryside, which we prefer. And you know, we've been completely out of season, but in season you would potentially meet more van people and have a little bit more social interaction.
Well, at the first one we did meet,
yeah, there were quite a few
van people. I think we stayed 2 nights, and you know, each night was a different crowd of people, and we met and then obviously chatted to the restaurant people and that as well. So, yeah.
So it was a better situation for us.
Yeah.
We did enjoy Italy. It is beautiful, but it has got its problems. Besides the crime, it's just a lot of people and the roads are just so narrow. So it's very difficult for us to decide where we're going to go.
Well, yeah, and Google Maps isn't always the most helpful with that.
No.
So, but anyway, we hope you enjoy the video. If you haven't, please subscribe. Please give us a thumbs up and like. And as usual, we always want some comments. Please give us comments. Let us know what you think.
That's it.
Thanks.
Goodbye.
Bye. See you on the next one.
This is then taken at the Agricamper near Florence. They produce mostly wine and olive oil. Apparently the olive oil is quite expensive here because the olives are very small, so they need a lot of oil, olives to press for their oil, which obviously adds to the costs. And I'm not quite sure what these are. I'll have to go and ask and find out. Sure if these trucks are protesting or what, but there's been a whole parade of them for kilometers long now with their flags. Just an example of all the little villages on the hills. We're on top of this very, very wide wall, which has been made into a walkway and a cycle path. This is overlooking the area outside. And we'll see if we can see some of the village off the inside.
Just such a pretty drive. We passed Luca to be on our way to the Cinque Terre.
All the bikers out for this Sunday morning. Right. Going for a breakfast run.
But it is just so pleasant with all the greens.
Thank you.
This is Cinque Terre, and the first village is Rio Maggiore, where we parked our car up high, and now we're going to walk down to it, and then we're going to take a train, which takes you from village to village. We are now walking down to Rio Maggiore. Lots and lots of steps going down. This is the very narrow hiking trail after having climbed 350 odd stairs, but it's so worth it. And we continue upwards. And that is the village that we're aiming for. Apparently it's another hour, but I think we've done the worst. Thank you. Up there is where we stop for our lemon drink. But the pathway's been quite nice now. Pretty much a little bit of a downhill. This then is Corniglia. Corniglia is also different because it's not on the beach. So from the train you have to climb up to it.
Traveling north, northeast really, aren't we? We've got the Alps. This is also called the Dolomite region in Italy. Southern Tyrol area in Italy, and these are all apple trees. It's known as the Golden Delicious area because of all the Golden Delicious apple trees. And a third of Italy's apple production is grown here in this region. Tonight we're staying at the Agricampers, which is an equestrian centre, but it's actually closed at the moment. So, not too many people around, but so pretty. We made it to this very nice little church on our walk. On our Agricampers.